The other FISA memo was dropped. The Democrats released their version of a declassified memo refuting claims in the Republican version of abuse by the FBI and the Department of Justice. The president called the response a bust. He told Fox News host Judge Jeanine Pirro this weekend, it only proves what he's been saying all along. Watch.
I will tell you, that was really just a confirmation of, if you call it the Republican memo or the Nunes memo, it's referred to as a lot of things, but that was nothing but a confirmation. And a lot of bad things happened on the other side, not on this side, but on the other side.
And you know what's interesting?
Somebody should look into it, because what they did is really fraudulent, and somebody should be looking into that. There is no collusion. No phone calls. I had no phone calls, no meetings, no nothing. There is no collusion.
And we keep seeing that, no evidence of it at all. Joining me right now in an exclusive Fox Business interview, House Intelligence Committee Chairman, California Congressman Devin Nunes. Congressman, it's good to see you.
It's great to see you.
Thanks so much for joining us, Mr. Chairman. We appreciate it very much. You've been busy, and people are grateful that you've been doing this. Now, the Democratic memo begins this way, and this is from the op-ed in the Journal today, Democrats for Eavesdrop Abuse, and this is what it says. The FBI and the DOJ officials did not abuse the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act process, omit material information, or subvert this vital tool to spy on the Trump campaign. Now, we know that the facts show the opposite.
Yeah, and what I said many times over the weekend since this came out is that the Republicans wanted this out because we believe it proves everything that we said in our memo to be true. We talked specifically about FISA abuse, and they are actually saying that it's okay for one party to essentially get dirt, use it to spy on another party. And that just is not, it's never going to be okay in America.
Now they said,
and I'll tell you the alarming thing that I think that I see here, Maria, is that the media is totally ignoring this. And so you have to ask yourself, why are they ignoring this? I think they're ignoring it because they saw the Steele dossier in 2016. Because you had Fusion GPS and the Democratic Party and the Hillary campaign were briefing many people in the press on the existence of the Steele dossier. They even had Christopher Steele, this former British spy, meet with many people within the media. And then, as we now know from the memo that we put out, there was actually one news story where Christopher Steele met with Yahoo News. That was actually picked up and used by the FBI to corroborate the Steele dossier. So it was like
so
a circular.
Acted as if it was like another piece of information. Meanwhile, it was based on the same dossier.
On the same information that has never been proven, that's totally unverified, and as the FBI said, salacious and unverified.
And they did that four times. They kept renewing the application, right?
Right. So that's the problem. Is that once the government was able to go in and get Carter Page's emails and get up on his phones to listen in on him, and go back and get all of his information. A few days after that, it came out that Christopher Steele, who had been a source before, had actually been terminated then by the FBI because they found out that he had talked to another news outlet. So at that point, the appropriate action would have been to go in and brief the court, you know, just days after they had gotten this warrant and say, okay, look, we made a mistake, because they largely based their warrant off of the Christopher Steele dossier that was paid for by the Democrats and then corroborated it with the Yahoo News story. So they didn't do it a few days after the first FISA warrant, and then they had three additional times to present that to the court, and they never did. And the bottom line with the court is this, that we can't have a secret court operate like this in America, where they're going to take and use it against political enemies, where one political party can use it against another. Just it's not going to work if that's going to be the case.
This is very troubling. I mean, you're the chairman of the Intel Committee. I mean, should we believe that the government is just spying on everybody willy-nilly? I mean, what does this tell us about our rights?
Well, I think what this is this was the people at the very top who became political and then decided to use this political dirt at the highest levels of government, and they just could never believe that President Trump won the election.
Right.
I mean, that's really what this is about, in my opinion. Because look, we've looked for collusion. You know, I said from the very beginning, I will be the first one to come out and say if there's any evidence of collusion whatsoever, I will come out and I will come on your show and say to the American people, look, we for sure know that the campaign was colluding with the Russians, and this is how we know it.
Right.
Now, when we found that, We did come on the shows, and we did say that we found collusion. The problem is everybody's ignoring it. We found collusion between the Democrats and the Russians, digging up dirt, phony dirt, and then funneling into the FBI to use it against the Trump campaign. We found collusion, but it's being ignored by everyone in the media except for basically Fox and the Wall Street Journal and a few others. How